Today on Matters of Fact, perhaps one of the most criticized agencies of government is the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority. Just look at the worsening traffic in Metro Manila and you'll know why. A new bill filed at the House of Representatives claims the MMDA has not been responsive to the concerns of residents in the National Capital Region. Under the proposal, the MMDA will be replaced by a regional government where the governor will be elected. But will a change in the power structure actually make any difference? Or perhaps the problem lies elsewhere? With us today is former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza, who is now the Buhay Party's representative. He filed House Bill number 4758. Later, we'll be joined on the phone by MMDA Chairman Tim Orbos. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Christian. Yeah. Thank you for inviting
us. Now, this proposal is not actually new because in the past we've been hearing this proposal that there should be an elected governor for Metro Manila. Now, what makes you think that this particular proposal will actually address this systemic problem that we have at the MMDA?
It's time to accept, Christian, that the present structure of governance we have in the metro region is not conducive to effective management. Because you have a chairman who's trying to assert his leadership and his influence on elected mayors.
Yeah.
By the very nature of the relationship between an appointed official and an elected local official, spells differences. Mm-hmm. And when it comes to a serious difference, the elected local official prevails. So yung nangyayari dyan, Chairman Orbos, even if he tries his best, and I know he's trying his best, he's doing his best, but there are problems that he will not be able to change or to address properly because of the situation. So we are proposing a structural improvement on the present system.
Or change. Now, under the present system, what is the scope of the responsibilities or power wielded by the MMDA chairman? Because the impression of the public is that this guy is very powerful, but in reality, he's just a coordinator.
Correct. And because of the daily requirements and stresses and pressures that the chairman is undergoing, he is, I'm sure, neglecting the primary task of the MMDA, and that is development planning.
For the entire region.
If we ask Chairman Orbos, have you started preparing the development plan of the region, mm-hmm. where we can all participate in? I'm sure. Sasabihin niyo sa'yo, alam mo, sa dami ng trabaho ko. Pagising ko sa umaga, problema na. Hanggang mahating kami nagtatrabaho ko.
In particular, traffic.
Traffic is one good example. When will we be able to really address the problem of traffic with infrastructure requirements, with strict discipline on the roads? Yan lang naman ang elemento dyan eh. Alisin natin yung mga bus terminals, EDSA, Buendia, and other main avenues
and
of Metro Manila.
On the streets.
And one of the main problems of traffic, I'm sure Chairman Orbos will agree, yung mga bus terminals where buses come in and out, blocking the flow of the traffic in our only freeway in Metro Manila, that's the EDSA freeway.
Now let's talk about that specific problem. How come under the present structure, the MMDA chairman cannot actually force mayors to pull out this bus terminal?
Because he has to work with them. He has to coordinate with them. Ayaw naman niyang awayan yung mga yan. Siyempre, pag sinabi ng mayor, huwag mo gagalawin yung bus terminal na yan. Binigyan ko ng permiso yan. Of course, they're all given permits. Kaya hindi maalis. Andyan. Pumunta ka sa Buendia, I see this every day. I tell you, nakakagalit eh. Yung Buendia, inayos ng gobyerno, niluwagan. Tapos yung palang kalahati gagamitin ng mga bus terminals. Diyan sa meron Buendia, tatabi nyo.
And it was permitted by the mayor.
And it's obviously, because otherwise, matagal ang tinigil yan.
So basically, you have this power problem.
Correct.
In terms of, you compare the local autonomy of the mayor and the responsibility of the chairman.
Correct.
As coordinator.
Correct.
Okay.
That's why what we're proposing is a structural reform by making the governor elected, and he is supported by a regional board, also elected representatives coming from all districts of Metro Manila.
So basically, you'll be following the present structure in the provinces.
In the provinces.
So you have a governor and you have a sangguniang panglalawigan.
And we can also take a look at how successful the metropolitan government of Tokyo, of Toronto, of New York. Merong metropolitan government yung mga yan eh. So that the problems are anticipated and the solutions are enforced. with no objection.
Let's talk about your specific experience while you were the mayor of Manila. It was common knowledge before, during the time of MMDA chairman Bayani Fernando. He's now a congressman,
correct,
like you.
And he's my good friend.
Yeah, yeah. But before you had this conflict in terms of policy.
Yes, because pag naisip ni Chairman Fernando nung araw, ayaw na niya magtanong, gagawin na niya. Mm. Naisip niya yung toilet na ilalagay sa sidewalk. Yeah. Ginawa niya yan. Eh, ayoko ng toilet sa sidewalk eh.
You were referring to the urinals.
The urinals. So,
painted pink, right?
Painted pink. At nagtayo yung mga tao niya na dalawang urinal sa harap ng ladies boarding house, Espanya. Pinalis ko agad. Sabi ko, what do you want here? You want men to be urinating in front of ladies' dormitories? Hindi tama, pero sa tingin ni Chairman Fernando, tama yun. Mm. Eh, sa tingin ng mayor ng Manila, hindi. Hindi niya nagawa.
So that was one example of clashes or conflicts between the chairman and the mayor.
Correct.
So I think, the impression with Chairman Fernando was that he had this very strong personality, that he could proceed whenever he wanted to.
Yes, and he meant well. Yeah. That the guy always meant well, but the only problem is that he was in an appointed position, and he couldn't assert himself and force himself over elected officials. Mm. You know, best example of what we are trying to address right now. We need to have an elected governor answerable to the people and not to the appointing power. Mm. And then he will be able to plan and execute and take care of the problems, the growing problems of a growing metropolis. Mm. Yun po naman ang aming purpose dito. And I'm sure congressman from Metro Manila will understand and will support the measure. And I'll explain it to the speaker, to our majority, para po naman pagtulong-tulungan namin.
Now, how will an elected governor in Metro Manila actually make things better? In reality,
how will this
solve the problem?
Again, sabi ko nga Christian, the principle of accountability. Well, to be realistic, saan ang accountability ng isang appointed official? As appointing power.
Who is the president?
Who is the president? But an elected official, governor, will always look at the electorate who has given him the authority.
But can't you go by the principle also that once you're appointed to a public office, you're also accountable to the people by virtue of your office?
That's technically said. But in reality, you're always, your boss is the appointing power. Mm-hmm. Iba yung elected by the people, your boss actually, genuinely, really, are the people who elect you to office.
Now, in reality, baka naman ang problema nasa mayors din sometimes. That's they make the chairman because he's appointed, they make him feel insecure. They want to wield so much power as by virtue of their local autonomy, and they make the chairman feel it.
Christian, that's one. We have to accept that's one of the problems. But the bigger problem is structurally speaking, hindi talaga pwede mag-blend yung appointed chairman and elected mayor. We have to change that. We have to accept the fact na hindi talaga naging effective ang metropolitan government sa Pilipinas, katulad ng mga metropolitan governments sa ibang parte ng mundo, dahil nga sa structural defect. Not because of the chairman appointed now and in the past, but because of the structural defect.
So the
there was only one time. There was only one time where the MMDA, which used to be known as Metro Manila Commission in 1973, na naging successful. Kasi ang chairman yan, si Mrs. Imelda Marcos.
And she was the first lady.
Correct, first lady and the wife of the dictator. Yeah. Let's accept it. The dictator of the country, and we were under martial law.
Okay.
Tumuturo pa lamang si Madam Imelda sa direksyon. Ang mga mayor sumusunod na. You had no choice. Pag hindi ka sumunod, tanggal ka.
So that was the exception. Now we have on the line MMDA Chairman Tim Orbos. Sir, good morning.
Hi, Christian. Good morning. Sir, Congressman, magandang umaga po.
Magandang umaga po, sir. We're talking about this proposal by Congressman Tito Chenza that there should be an elected governor for Metro Manila. Basically, he's trying to change the power structure for Metro Manila and replace the MMDA with a Metro Manila government. Now, he's talking about this inherent conflict because of the systemic problem wherein you have the MMDA chairman being appointed by the president and he has to deal with the 17 mayors all over Metro Manila who are actually elected and who enjoy specific local autonomy. Now, let's talk about your actual experience. Do you actually feel this at the MMDA, that somehow there's this inherent conflict between your responsibility as at the MMDA and with the responsibilities of the respective mayors?
It's really very difficult because as it is, it has nothing to do with who is chairman, but in fact, it has something to do with the powers, the present powers right now that the MMDA has. So, tama po si Congressman, nung panahon po ni First Lady, and let's look at that. That was the essence of putting up MMDA, diba? To make this really an agency that would really look after the concerns of Metro Manila. At that time, it was well because all the powers were there, not only because of Mrs. Marcos, but because the powers inherent in an MC at that time were a lot stronger than what we have right now. Ngayon po, we're just purely a more or less a coordinating body, and as it is, I need to coordinate. In fact, I cannot even make my own. We cannot even make our own ordinances. We need to go through a council, and the council, each mayor will have to come up with their own similar ordinances. It's also high time, I guess, in with what's happening right now. It's high time to challenge this particular law creating the MMDA. It's high time simply because the Metro Manila needs it. Iba ho talaga ang problema ng Metro Manila. At the same time, pinag-uusapan na rin ho natin yung federal government. I think this is one good reason why we really need to review and then really consider a federalist form of government. Metro Manila should be taken as a separate region, and therefore an elected authority must be there. But ang hingin ko lang kay Congressman is really to go further. Yung po authority ng iba po kasi ang Metro Manila, and I'm sure Congressman Atienza knows this, yung pong franchising powers must be with us. It should not be with the national government. Yung pong urban development, yung pong housing must be with us. It should not be with the national government. So I fully agree. But I would like to ask the congressman to dagdagan na po natin. Nandiyan na rin lang po tayo, pag-uusapan na rin lang po natin sa Kongreso yan. Might as well review what was the original intent of President Marcos at that time and try to bring back what is taken out, and then see if this is really something that we can work on, and then it becomes a model for what the president wants right now, which is going to a federal form of government. Uh-huh.
Mm. So you're in favor of the proposal to have an elected governor for Metro Manila, and actually you want the proposal to actually go further. Now let's talk about your specific problems at the MMDA. For example, traffic. Based on public perception, that seems to be the primary concern of the MMDA. But in reality, you also have other concerns. And Congressman Atienza was mentioning the issue of urban planning. Let's talk about traffic, for example. What specific problems have you been encountering with other mayors in terms of a unified approach to solve traffic, the problem in Metro Manila?
Well, even without discussing first the problems that we have with the other cities, let's talk about enforcement. At the time when President or the First Lady was the head of MMC, we had what? I think around 5,000 enforcers. With a population that was a lot less than what we have right now, and then the number of vehicles a lot less than what we have right now. Right now, we only have about 2,000 or half of it. Street sweepers, we had around, if I'm not mistaken, during the time of when it was first established, I think there were around 14,000 street sweepers. Right now, we have 5,000. So that alone, you can see the magnitude of a problem that we are now encountering, considering that we have less resources of which I have to secure from the mayors. I have to secure, aside from the ones that I'm the one that I'm getting from the national government, I need to secure my budget from the mayor. So in a way, ako po yung pong gusto ni Congressman Atienza, there is reason for it, and I believe that this needs to be discussed right now. And it's not just about talking if this is going to be an elected position or this is going to be appointed position. The strength, the power of MMDA must be put on the table, must be discussed, must be debated. And because this is Metro Manila, we're talking here of 40% of all of our resources here. We need to put the attention required for Metro Manila in place.
Okay. Thank you very much for joining us this morning, MMDA Chairman Tim Orbos. Good morning.
Morning po.
Now, let's talk about that particular proposal by Chairman Orbos. He mentioned something about going further with that proposal, that this could serve as a model for the proposed federal system of government, and also actually this can be absorbed under that proposal.
The correctness of the observation is based on experience. Yeah. I'm sure alam na ni Chairman Orbos ang problema niya. He has a gigantic burden with a very limited power. Yeah. So tama yun. The elected governor will have to be supported by the principle of local autonomy also.
Yeah.
He has to be given all the autonomous powers of developing, planning the development of his region, which is the metropolitan region. It will automatically be falling on the lap of the elected governor, all the powers that Chairman Orbos is now wishing for. Housing, peace and order, planning the infrastructure requirements of the metropolitan area.
But when you proposed this, were you thinking of the bigger picture of having a federal system of government in the Philippines?
I am not connecting it directly because I am not convinced that the answer to our problems in the country now is federalism. Mm. I am basically not in favor of it. I am for a stronger implementation of the intent of the Constitution now, which is upholding local autonomy.
So I believe the local government code?
Yeah. Not only code, but the local autonomy principle.
Yeah.
Kailangan bigyan ng kapangyarihan ng mga local government units para sila magplano at sila magtulak ng development sa kanilang mga local unit. Yung federalism is a very risky experiment.
Yeah.
We may not be able to sustain development in many of our regions for lack of any economic capability. Metro Manila has no problem.
Yeah.
We can be an autonomous state in a federalized system.
But the other regions.
But what about the Bicol area? What about some regions in
Eastern Visayas?
Eastern Visayas. Pwede ba silang tumayo on their own? Baka tayo mapagsamantalahan ng mga Banyaga. No. Sila papasok dito. Baka bilhin na lang nila yung mga region natin for their own selfish motives.
No, you